गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? यस, आई एम फाइन एंड आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन. सो इन द सोशल साइंस वी स्टडी अबाउट सो मेनी सब्जेक्ट एंड इट इज़ वेरी वास्ट सब्जेक्ट. यस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी स्टडी अबाउट द हिस्ट्री. यस, सो व्हाट इज हिस्ट्री? यस, हिस्ट्री इज अ स्टडी ऑफ पास्ट इवेंट्स. ओके, एंड नेक्स्ट पॉलिटिकल साइंस. यस, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय पॉलिटिकल साइंस? यस यस, सो पॉलिटिकल साइंस स्टडीज अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द मैन एंड द गवर्नमेंट. यस, सो वी स्टडी अबाउट हियर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ राइट्स एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स. यस, एंड पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. यस, एक्सेट्रा. यस, and next one is geography. yes, so what we study in the geography? yes, so we study in the geography the earth and the different types of layers in the atmosphere. yes, and the nature. yes, and economics. so we study in the economics, that is the type of economics. yes, and the sources is and the transaction of bankings. yes, and also business studies. yes, so in the business studies we studies about the business and industries. yes, there are different types of industries and we will study about the all the different types of industries and the organizations of business. so do you have any idea about sociology? yes, what we study in the sociology? yes, so don't you know? so let's see sociology. yes, so sociology, it is also an important subject in the social science. yes, so because man is an social animal. yes, as you know, so we can't live without social. yes, that is we can't live without society. yes, and human beings are different from other animals and it has intellectual beings. yes, so if you compare to the different types of animal, so human beings, he is very different because we have a capacity of thinking. yes, if you compare to the animals, they don't have any capacity of thinking, but the human being, we have the thinking power and that's why it is very different than the other animals. yes, and there are a lot of differences between animals and human beings. yes, so that is, for example, body structure and the rate of growth and food consumption. yes, and the creativity and evolution in brain can be noticed. yes, so these are the some differences between the animal and human body. yes, so let's see first chapter of your social science, that is introduction to sociology. so what do you mean by sociology? yes, so let's see the meaning of sociology. yes, as you know, human beings are a social beings. yes, and we can't live without society. yes, because we are depending each other for different needs. yes, so let's see the meaning of sociology. yes, the word sociology, it originates from two words. yes, the term, that is the sociology, it originates from two terms. first one is socius, so it's from Latin language. yes, and next one is logos. yes, so it's from Greek language. so let's see what is socius. yes, so socius means companion. yes, so socius means companion and logos means science or study. yes, and thus sociology is the science of human society. yes, so what is the meaning of sociology? that is the sociology, it is the science of human society. okay, so let's see some definitions of sociology. yes, So according to Auguste Comte, yes. So he gave the definition of sociology. Let's see what is the sociology according Auguste Comte. Yes. So sociology is the science of social phenomena subject to the natural and invariable laws, and the discovery of which is the object of investigation. Yes, that is sociology. It is also a science. Yes, and that is of that is subject to the natural and invariable laws, and the discovery of which is the object of investigation. Yes, next one is Max Weber. Yes, that is, he said that sociology is a study of social behavior. Yes, what we study in the sociology, that is we study about the social behavior. Yes, and next one is Emily Durkheim. Yes, what he says, he says sociology is the science of social institutions. Yes, what is sociology? That is sociology, it is a science, social institution of the science. Yes, that is totally sociology is, it is nothing but it is a study of social behavior. Yes, so in generally one can define that is sociology is as the study of human society. Yes, in the sociology we will study about the human society. So let's see origin of sociology. Yes, how it grow, let's see. Yes, the beginning of sociology as an independent and separate field of science was during the middle of 19th century. Yes, in the beginning the sociology is an independent subject. Yes, and it has a separate field of science during the middle of 19th century, and later it became a specific science in latter 50 years. And though other social science like history, political science, economics, psychology and others have longer history, they were recognized as a social sciences during 18th and 19th century. Yes, there are so many subjects in the social science like political science, economics, psychology and other subjects like history. Yes, so it has a longer history, and they were recognized as social science during the 18th and the 19th century. Yes, and this was due to the industrial and French revolutions, the intellectual stimulations provided by social and religious reforms movements, Renaissance and other movements of 16th and 18th resulted in the origin of sociology. Yes, so let us see the scope of sociology. Yes, so as we know, sociology studies the human society, and it studies human social life, social relationship and social institutions and social process. So this is all about the scope of sociology. Yes, so first of all it studies about the human. Yes, and also it studies the human social life and what is the relation between the social and the human, and also there are so many institutions. Yes, so how is the relationship with the that all institutions with the human life. So we will study about that is the scope. It is also a scope of sociology. So let's see nature of sociology. So sociology has a unique place among all the social science. Yes, and it is different from other social science due to its unique nature. Yes, and sociology is considered as an independent and separate field of study, and the futures of sociology, let's see. First one is sociology is a social science or not a physical science. Yes, so sociology, it belongs to group of social science and it is not to the group of physical sciences. So it is a social science, but it is not a group of physical science. And also it studies the social life and activities of human society. Yes, and it also has a close relationship with other social science like history, political science, economics, psychology and anthropology. So that's why sociology is a social science and it is not a physical science. So next one is sociology is a definite study but not a directive study. Yes. So sociology studies human society as it is. Yes. So it never engages in how it should be studied. Yes. And it does not engage in value judgments. And also it aims at objectives study only. Yes. So their main objective or the main aim is only for the study of the society. And sociology remains neutral in value-based aspects. Yes. So next one is sociology is a pure science and not an applied science. Yes. So sociology is interested in objective studies that resulted in the formation of empirical body knowledge only. And it is not an applied science which is interested in experiment. Yes. In the science we can do there so many experiment, but in the sociology we can't do any experiment. Yes. So next one is sociology is an intangible science and not a tangible science. Yes. So as we know, sociology is not interested in some of the tangible aspect of human life, and it has interest in the form and pattern of human events. Yes. And also it has no interest in any specific battle or revolution like history. Yes. Just it studies only the human life, and it considers these events as patterns and forms of social conflict and subject them to a scientific study. So that's why sociology is a intangible science and not a tangible science. Next one is sociology is a general science and not a special science. Yes. So among all the social science, only sociology studies the general interactions involving human beings like religion, politics and economy and moral and intellectual aspect, and it has a wider scope than other social sciences. So this is all about nature of sociology. So let's see importance of sociology. Yes. Though sociology is the youngest science among all the social science, and its uses are universal. So let's see what are the uses or what are the importance of sociology. Yes. So first one is sociology studies human society scientifically. Yes, as you know, so sociology basic aim is to study human society by the scientifically. Yes. And the sociology construct a systematic body of knowledge of human society with its scientific study, and this aids progress in other fields of human life. One is supplements the personality development. Yes, human beings in mainly a social being who is often expected to get adjusted to the changing nature of society. And by creating holistic understanding of social structure, growth and changes, and individual responsibilities, sociology facilitates holistic personality development. Next one is understanding social process. Yes, sociology aids the proper understanding of social process by studying the religions, traditions, culture, social rules and regulations, values and ideals of other various society. And also sociology is very helpful in understanding the interrelationship of various social institutions. Yes. Next one is aids in understanding social problems and their solutions. So every society suffers from its own social problems. Yes. And our society is facing many problems like crime, juvenile crime and communal clashes, alcoholism, hunger, malnutrition, caste-based discrimination and unemployment, gambling, prostitution, child labor, inequality and various other problems. So these are the some problems which are in our Indian society. And a scientific study of these problems provide better insights which aids in scientific solutions. So sociology studies these all problems and it also provides their solution. Next one is sociology supports the effective implementation of development programs. Yes. So by studying human society scientifically, sociology aids the effective implementation of development programs. So let's see next one, the interrelationship between sociology and other social science. Yes. So sociology is the youngest subject among all the social sciences and it has its own field of study and has interrelationship with other social sciences as well. So let us see first one, relationship between sociology and political science. So there is a close relationship between sociology and political science because these two belongs to the society. Yes, and the political science, it studies the interaction between political institutions, political life of human beings and political institutions of human society. Yes, and the sociology, it also studies the various social institutions like social group and social institutions that functions within the political structure. So this is the relationship between political science and sociology. So let's see next one, what is the relationship between sociology and history? Yes, so sociology and history are interrelated. Yes, and history is the recreation of the life of past society. Yes, as we know, history is the it is a study of past events. And the sociology is the recreation of contemporary society, and sociology supports historians by providing scientific knowledge of various social institutions and their roles and functions. Next one is, so relationship between the sociology and anthropology. So the relationship between sociology and anthropology are widely recognized, and the culture and the social path of human beings and its history is studied by anthropology. And sociology grows independently by studying the social life holistically, and also it provides objective analysis of the various social institutions. So let's see next one difference between, that is the relationship between sociology and psychology. Yes, so sociology and psychology are complementary to each other. And the psychology studies the behavioral aspect of human beings from psychological perspective, and sociology seeks to study the social behavior and social interactions and functions of social institutions. Next one is relationship between sociology and economics. So economics, it studies the economical activities of human beings, whereas sociology seeks to understand the interaction between economical and social activities of human beings. Yes, and also it also proves how human behavior forms the economic activities. So in totally, while analyzing the social behavior and sociology with other social sciences is in its own way. So this is all about the relationship between sociology and other social sciences. So thank you for watching video, and I hope all of you understood this. So in the next class, we will go for the next topic, that is the early sociologist. Thank you.